Welcome to OC Review Number 1, guys. Let's get started, boys. This is less of a review and more of a suggestions, and I'm gonna toss questions your way kind of video. She used to live in Japan, but only stayed for 5 years. Her mother sent her to an English-speaking country because things were happening and her father was abusive. Oh, poor girl. It is always sad to hear about stuff that goes on like that. May I ask what country and who she lived with? Was it a family friend? How did she get into the country? Depending on the country, it could have different immigration laws. I only know a bit about American laws. In an orphanage, the kids teased her for her accent and appearance. In middle school, she was called overweight, so she began an eating disorder that lasted a year. Unfortunately, this is a common thing and it sucks, honestly. Did she ever get fully over the disorder? Did she have anyone in her corner after? Support groups. Did she reach out to her mother? In high school, she was sexually harassed. How though? Unwarranted touching, vulgar language, harassment, stalking. By who? Was this person close to her? A stranger? Why was this added in? What do you want the reader to feel when mentioning this? Then a few days after her 16th birthday, she was hit by a car, dying in a hospital due to the injuries. So she is a ghost character, or undead, or is her story just of her life before she died? What caused the car accident? Race. Japanese language is spoken. English and Japanese parents. She doesn't remember how they look or their names. Not that she wants to. Why would she not want to remember her mother? From what I've read, she only wanted to give her a better future. This brings up the question, did the mother intend to follow her daughter at a later date but was stopped? Did she try to keep contact with Tyler at all? She has a rather bubbly personality until it comes to personal topics like what it was like in Japan and stuff. It reminds her of her parents and it makes her emotional. She likes making friends who accept her for her personality, not how she looks. She can't cook, which she doesn't mind. Was she like this when she was alive? I equate bubbly to peppy a bit, so I have a hard time thinking she didn't at least have a few friends around. Maybe even some really close, almost familial ones. Spending her time in an orphanage would give them something to bond over. There isn't much to go off of personality-wise here. Bubbly is a broad statement and kind of hard to understand. Maybe go into more detail on how she acted around other people, or how she reacts to certain things. Okay. So that was a lot. I'ma do a TLDR right now. Here are my suggestions. Give her a few close friends. Usually, no matter how hard it gets, there is always someone who will stand by your side. Maybe they could be in the same class or from similar backgrounds. Not everyone follows the leader. There would be some who would stick by her side. Expand on why the mother is not there or why she seems to not make any appearance besides loving Tyler enough to give her a better life outside of the country, and maybe explain how she got to the other country. And be careful with the sexual harassment part. It can be done well, but it's still a touchy subject with most people. Most of my suggestions just equate to expanding on certain points. Since I'm more of a story-driven person, I am mostly useless for reviews on looks. Sorry about that. On a scale of 1 to 5, I rate this a 3. Meaning I would read it if certain points were fleshed out a bit. Overall, Tyler is a good character. Few cliches, but not enough to warrant a Mary Sue title. Stuff I like about this character: her origin, her recovery from her eating disorder, how she died. There is nothing major I would change, if I'm honest. The eyes and hair confuse me, but a bit of an explanation would clear that right up. Just keep in mind, expanding and details are your friends. And always remember who you're writing this for. Yourself. Do what you love. Whoa.